Welcome. In this video, I will give you a quick tutorial on how to use Parallax Maker and the general workflow that it supports. We will turn this still image into an amazing animation with an AI-generated metal rock track. The project starts by dragging an image into the main pane. Once you give it an image, it will compute a depth map that will allow us to segment the image into regions. Each region will become its own card that will be placed at different depth coordinates in the scene we are creating. I am adjusting the thresholds until they seem about right. This will be our starting point and does not need to be perfect. The general workflow is going to be segmentation, inpainting, and then 3D scene generation to export to Blender or Unreal Engine. Let's create the slices, and then I will need to do some cleanup. The inpainting workflow allows me to remove areas of an image that I do not want. It will also allow creation of new image data, as you will see shortly. To do more targeted cleanup, let's switch over to instance segmentation. With instance segmentation, you can click anywhere in the image, and it will select the object that you clicked on. It's like magic. In our case, this magic is supported by the powerful Segment Anything model from Meta AI. While I'm cleaning up, let me explain that what you are seeing is a Python application I wrote that's running on my local computer. I have now selected the background card and will work on filling in the areas that are obscured by our awesome guitar performer. To do so, I'm masking the area I want to inpaint and prompt the Stable Diffusion XL model to create the additional image data. As I wrote this tool in a few evenings, the user interface is not the easiest. In this case, you always have to save your mask before you can use it. The model will give you three results to choose from. I'm hoping for more clearly visible bricks on the back wall. After committing the inpainting, I can do a quick test and see how it works. That looks good to me. Let's move on. You will see me moving back and forth between cleanup and inpainting. I will also switch back and forth between the different slices until I'm happy with the results. The benefit of the inpainting process is that it uses a surrounding image as the context for creating the patch. You can influence this via the diffusion strength and the prompt guidance scale. The higher the strength, the more the changes can deviate from the input image. You might wonder why I spent time writing this tool. I'm wondering about it myself. I'm working on a mobile game to teach some concepts of music theory in an ambient setting. For this game, I needed to build introductory scenes for each musical mode. I thought I would use parallax animation for that, and then discovered that I really disliked doing the work in Photoshop. Since I had to create 7 levels for the main modes, it seemed easier to just write the code. I'm getting close to giving this scene a quick test in 3D. While the in-browser 3D view is not the best, it helps with finding potential problems. A neat trick here is to compute a depth map on each slice and then displacing each slice in 3D space to give the scene even more depth. I've found a few problems where the images were not cleaned up well, so I'm going to do some more canvas painting and then remove unnecessary pixels. The process here is pretty iterative, but I hope you can see how a specialized tool is a huge time saver. For me, it was also an opportunity to have some fun writing code. It's sort of relaxing and engaging. I got sucked into it so much that my guitar practice suffered. Oh well. For the background card, I'm essentially inpainting the whole image. You can also see how it requires iterations on the prompt and the parameters. I'm not showing everything here, and the video is already sped up quite a bit. Before creating the production scene, I'm upscaling all textures by a factor of 2. This will help when the camera moves into the scene and gets so close to the images that they need to be in a higher resolution. The final step is to export the glTF scene that we can import into Blender. Blender has great support for this format. Without making a lot of changes, we can render an animation from Blender by configuring the camera and then animating it over time. In this case, I wanted slightly aggressive animation to play along with the AI-generated aggressive rock grunge track. That's it. All the code is released as open source on GitHub, and if you have a modern GPU, you should be able to run it and quickly create your own 2.5D animations. Enjoy! Enjoy. I will see you next time. The skeleton trains are caught in roll, I sit there, it's tearing up the stairs.